A metal worker clamps the disc against a form in a lathe. As the lathe spins, he presses the disc to the form using a blunt tool. This transforms the disc into a flared vessel, one that looks like a flower pot. A cutter at the side trims the rim. They call this flower pot shape the draft. A worker presses the spinning draft to another form. This stretches the aluminum shape longer and narrower. Finally, they taper the cylinder at the top to form a slanted chimney and slice off the bottom. He drills a hole in the gradient of the kettle. He inserts a screw that's attached to a punch. Then, using an Allen wrench, he turns the screw, forcing the punch into the metal to cut out a hole for the kettle spout. He now slides the kettle body over a post with a die that fits into the spout hole. He places the spout over the die and hammers it into the hole. Next, the inner wall of the Ghillie kettle takes shape. Wielding a tool with force, a worker pulls and stretches the aluminum disc into a long cone. He inserts the cone in the kettle body. The gap between them will serve as the water chamber, and smoke will be vented out the center. He rolls the upper lip of the cone around the kettle's top rim, locking them together. He also secures them at the base the same way. He transfers the Ghillie kettle to a stand to keep it upright as he rivets steel ears to it. The ears are for attaching the handle and a chain for the kettle whistle. The base of the Ghillie kettle is this fire chamber. For packing purposes, he stacks it upside down and places the kettle over it. He wraps the entire kettle in British newsprint for shipping. This protects it and also gives the purchaser something to burn the first time he or she tries it out. He crimps the ends of the handle to the ears that protrude through the headlines. He places the whistle over the wrapped spout and then tucks the kettle into a drawstring tote.